I've heard the arguments online, seen the arguments about whether or not it's a good idea or safe to venture out into the wilderness alone. The truth is, I have a very strong opinion on this subject, and though I have mentioned it multiple times and even skirted this subject a few times right here on this channel, I felt it necessary to make a video dedicated to this topic. Should you take your Jeep or your off-road vehicle out on a trail run all by yourself? You know what? The answer may not be what you want to hear, but stick around, because a lot of you need to hear this. Welcome back to Jeeping for Beginners, folks. Once again, my name is Josh, and today we are discussing the topic of whether or not you should venture out into the wilderness all by yourself. Now, there is an argument for both sides as to yes, it's a great idea, or no, you really shouldn't do it. And truth is, there are even several videos right here on this channel talking about what you should have with you, being supplies, recovery gear, tools, so on and so forth, should you decide to make the journey. But I felt it necessary to put this video together and make it abundantly clear to answer this question officially. Should you take your vehicle all by yourself and venture out here all alone? The short answer is no, you should never go out alone. Why? Because you just don't know what could happen. You could bump into an environmental catastrophe, major mechanical failure, personal injury, or you know what? Even worse. So no, you should never go out alone. And I've been a huge advocate for this on this channel for years and throughout my entire off-roading career. So officially, I'm going with the answer no, but let's dig into this a little bit deeper and let's talk about circumstances. All right, folks, so look at it this way, all right? This channel is dedicated to the newbie, the beginner, basically those people without any experience in the jeeping world or the off-roading world altogether. And I am here to give you advice on how to navigate that. But let's put this into perspective here real quick, okay? Let's say one day you just randomly decided to hop behind the controls of a commercial jet and fly to Thailand. Do you think that's really a good idea? No, you need years worth of experience and training and education before you're just gonna be even allowed to hop behind the controls of a commercial plane and fly halfway around the world. So why wouldn't the same be true when it comes to off-roading, when it comes to jeeping, when it comes to exploring? So remember, I am not talking to the guys with 20 plus years of experience. I'm talking to you, those who are brand new at this and looking for advice on how to navigate this world. Okay, so I'll just reiterate, if you're new to this sport, if you're new to Jeep ownership, if you're new to this world, no, do not go out alone. Why? Because you do not have the experience. You haven't had to conquer that obstacle. You haven't had to deal with that mechanical failure. You don't know what situation Mother Nature might throw at you. Now, after a few years worth of experience and some time, yes, maybe you've got a little bit more under your belt that'll tell you, hey, I know what my limits are. But as a new person in this field, and you just want to go out and explore because it's very enticing. And don't get me wrong, I want you to go out and enjoy the beauty that this country has to offer. But if you don't know what you're getting into, you don't know what your limits are, you don't know how far you can push yourself, how far you can push your rig, then you end up in a situation that you may not be able to control. So, good rule of thumb, if you have to question it, turn around. Now, I want you to understand, I'm not talking about driving down a dirt road to go to the lake. okay? I'm not talking about engaging the four-wheel drive in a snowstorm because you need to be able to get home. I'm talking about trail running. I'm talking about exploration that takes you miles and miles away from civilization where your cell phone won't work and where, frankly, nobody can hear you scream. Do you really want to be in that position and have something go wrong? All right, so please do not take this the wrong way, okay? After several years of having some experience under your belt and knowing the layout on the same trails over and over again, and you're comfortable with it, okay, maybe, because you know your limits. You know what the limits of your vehicle are. You probably have a little bit more experience using that recovery gear, like your traction boards and your winch and stuff, should you need it. Don't get me wrong. But I can tell you, even guys with 20 plus years under their belt will not venture out into the unknown all by themselves. It's just not safe. So folks, please keep this in mind that no, you really shouldn't do it by yourself. It can be an extremely dangerous sport if it's not respected for what it is. I'm a huge advocate for this world. I am a huge advocate for getting out, enjoying your Jeep, enjoying nature, and seeing what you can see. But I also am a huge advocate for you making it home safely to your family and home safely to do it another day. That is really the important part. And that's really the question that a lot of people are really skipping over here is it safe or comfortable to go out all by yourself? Well, I mean, we go to the mall by ourselves. We go to work by ourselves. All right, fine. But, you know, you make it home every day, and that's my goal, is I want you to make it home. Here's an interesting little tidbit. Did you know that in most areas of this country, especially where off-roading is legal, that if you were to get stuck or in a jam or in a situation where you needed some help from a third-party source, the minimum charge is like $2,000 for somebody to come out there and help you out. So not only could you be putting yourself at risk, be putting your life in danger, you could also be in a situation where you can't even afford to have the help necessary to come and get you. Why even create a situation like that to begin with? Now, overlanding is becoming extremely popular, and people's work schedules have gotten even more demanding. So, yeah, sometimes it is a little difficult to put a group together, but groups are always best. I mean, truth be told, since you never know what you're going to run into, it's always better to have that spread out experience among three or four different people. But you know what? I still get asked questions like, well, Josh, we see you out in your videos all by yourself. Okay, well, yeah, truthfully, this is a dirt road. Technically, this is my backyard. I'm only maybe a half a mile away from my house. I know this area extremely well, and I just come out here to shoot these videos so that it's a nice level of scenery out here. I don't even use my four-wheel drive. I don't need it. So just keep that in mind, that there is a difference between going out alone where it's extreme versus just two-wheel drive down to the lake. Now, I've even had a couple people say, well, Josh, I've seen you do it. I've seen you go out alone on major adventures. In fact, I got a video that's going to be uploaded on the channel here in the next couple of weeks about a solo adventure across the entire state of New Mexico. But is that always the right way to do it? Let me explain, okay? In fact, I am going to put a link to a video at the very end of this one that I want you guys to see, okay? It was just me and a friend, and it was one vehicle. We were on a road trip. We were just out having a good time. We were exploring some museums and hooking up with some friends and so on and so forth, and we got a wild hair across our ass and decided, hey, you know what? Let's, instead of taking the highway system across northern Nevada and northern Utah and Wyoming, let's take this trail that we found. It's rated a 1 out of 10. It was basically a campground. So it should be easy peasy and a breeze, right? I want you to watch this video because this is the perfect example of things getting out of control, all right? Truth be told, everything you can think of that was completely unexpected that could happen when you're out in the middle of nowhere by yourself actually happened to us, to the point where we almost found ourselves in grave danger. So it really doesn't matter the circumstances. Please don't try to justify it. Please don't try to make excuses for it. Just be smart about it, because at the end of the day, there's somebody at home that's gonna miss you. You need to be able to make it home. Seriously, watch that video, because the whole concept of doing this all by yourself, that video could actually shed some light on what really could happen, because it really did happen. All right, guys, so let me just finish this by saying this. No. I do not believe that it is a good idea to go out and venture into the unknown all by yourself, frankly, regardless of how much experience you have. However, if you are going to go out alone, if it is a must and you insist upon doing it, please remember three things. One, be safe and smart about what you're doing. If you're not sure you can make it through something or not sure about the conditions, turn around. Don't risk it. Two, make sure you always have enough water and supplies with you to be able to withstand at least a day longer than you're actually planning on being out there. Why? Because you really never know what's going to happen. And third, please keep in mind, you need to be able to make it home alive. That's really all that matters. If you can promise yourself 100% that you can accomplish all three of those and make it home with no problem whatsoever, then I say it's your call. I don't believe in hypocrisy. I've gone out and I've done it alone by myself too. I've learned a lot of lessons I probably shouldn't have had to learn. I don't think it's a good idea. I told you I got a video coming up about doing a solo trip across New Mexico. Following immediately behind that, when we continued up through Colorado, we ended up with a group. We ended up with a full-size group. Why? Because it really was the unknown. And believe it or not, it came in handy, because we had mechanical failure, Mother Nature coming at us, we got attacked by bears, and almost did not make it home. And that was with a group. So seriously, folks, just please be safe and be smart about it. Now listen, once again, my name is Josh. This is Jeeping for Beginners. If you do have any questions about this, whether you agree with what I say or you don't agree with what I say, you feel free to put it down in the comments down below. Or if you want a private conversation, you can always reach out to me at yasmarproductions@gmail.com. In the meantime, folks, stay safe. Please stay safe. Happy jeeping, so that we will see you next time.